So let's start. So here I am on my laptop and we are using Blender software. Blender software is basically a 3D animation and modeling software in which you can create 3D animation, 3D models and stuff like that. Today we are going to create Corona. Just a word about coronavirus. No one knows how it looks. The only reason I'm creating this video is for you guys to know how to create it in 3D. There is no other reason to create this video live here. No one knows how it looks, no one knows how coronavirus looks, but all the news channels, all the media houses are in the need of 3D images of coronavirus. So as an animator, we should be able to create such images. So that's why I'm doing it live stream here, so that you guys can understand and learn how to create it in 3D animation software Blender. So let's start. So first of all, what we'll do is, first we will add a metaball. This is not something that I'm teaching exactly on my tutorial series, but yeah, let's duplicate it. And we just want to create the spikes of coronavirus. If you have seen the coronavirus, you can know that there are some spikes. So we are just trying to create the spikes here. So it looks like a spike right now. You can see this looks like a spike. So what we are going to do is, we are going to make it a mesh. And once it's a mesh, now you can see the spike has been created. What we'll be doing is, we will be rotate 90 degrees or rotate again. So this is one of the spikes of coronavirus. We'll be creating a sphere, and on that sphere we'll be putting up too many spikes like such. So let's move it aside for a moment. Let's add a sphere as the base of coronavirus. So this is the base for the coronavirus. And now what we are going to do is, we are going to give it some texture to give it a feel of, you know, some ridges and something like is there. Right now it is looking just pure, clean, simple sphere. We don't want that. What we will do is, we will give it a displace modifier. I'm just moving up myself aside so that you can see what's happening. Cool. So we just gave it a modifier of displacement in the this modifiers panel here. We used this and displacement modifier. We gave it a displacement. Now let's add a new texture, and the texture has to be in this texture panel. We will be using clouds. So as you can see, some spikes have been already created. We don't want so much of noise there. It's too high. It's too detailed. We will just decrease the strength. Something like this will work well. Good. This now looks good. Maybe a little bit less. Now this looks good. Now what we will do is, we will add particle system to it. Now what particle system is and all these stuffs are, you can learn it on the tutorial series that I'm doing on Blender. So we'll use the hair particle system. So of course we don't want hairs. We want this as the hair on this object, on this sphere. So here we go for advanced, and in the rendered section we select render as, and not as a path. We want the object. Which object? This one. So we'll just from here, instance object, we'll just pick it up, and that's it. You can see here that it has picked it up, but the length is too high, so we'll just decrease the hair length. Yeah. Cool. So now as you can see, the particles are there, but the orientation is completely messed up. So what we need to do is, we need to change the orientation of this one for it to reflect there. So we'll just go to the edit mode, select all, and rotate it in X direction in minus 90. Let's see if it has worked. Yes, almost. Just the problem is the origin. Now here, if I just go to the top view, you can see this small yellow dot is the origin. We don't want the origin to be here. We want the origin to be here. So in the edit mode itself, we are in the edit mode. I'm just going to do grab and move it upwards. So let's say I want the origin to be here. So what is the use of origin? The particles that are being attached here will be attached from the origin point. So just we change the origin point to be down right here. Now let's move out of the object mode. You can see it's already looking really great. Now let's just look at the comment sections, if you have any comment sections. YG Academy says, sir, Marathi madhun sangitla tar jasta samjel, please. Sir, problem asa ahe ki he sadhya ek English channel ahe. Mi prayatna karel ki hech videos eka yas channel var Marathi madhe ani Hindi madhe takne. Hindi madhe takne sa prayatna karel, Marathi chi mi guarantee deu nahi shakat. Sir, video vyavasthit disat nahi. व्हिडिओ जर व्यवस्थित दिसत नाही आहे, मी रेकॉर्ड करत आहे हा व्हिडिओ आणि हा व्हिडिओ मी पुन्हा एकदा यूट्यूब चॅनलवर पुन्हा टाकेन. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू. दिस इज व्हॉट वी हॅव गॉट. नाऊ लेट्स चेंज द साईज बिकॉज द साईज इज टू लेस. लेट्स गो टू द पार्टिकल सेक्शन फॉर दिस. द साईज इज टू लेस, लेट्स जस्ट इन्क्रीज द साईज. द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स इज ऑल्सो टू हाय. Let's just make it 500 or maybe less, 400 or maybe even less, 300. That's it. Let's change the seed. Good, now it's looking really great. What we are going to do is we are just going to hide this away or maybe move it far away from the object. Good. So now the base of the coronavirus is already there. Now we want to do the shading part. So let's go to the shading panel. Here in the shading panel, now all these things that I am doing here, these are not in detail. If you want to learn these things in detail, then please do follow my YouTube channel, subscribe the YouTube channel, and there you will find a tutorial section for Blender. So there you can see all the things that I am doing here in detail. So that is it for that. Let's create a new material for this. And for the materials part, let's just make it right here. Now what we want is we want a diffuse texture which we will connect it here. Now we can give colors to it, right? What we want, we don't want a single color, we want some noise texture. So we will be adding a noise texture. And noise texture is basically black and white in color, which we don't want. You can see here it is black and white in color. We don't want it in black and white color, so we are going to add a color ramp node to change the colors and to give some control over the fall off, right, for the noise texture. So I'm selecting the black handle here and changing the color from here. Let's make it pinkish. And for the white, let's go for something like blue, something like this. Now you can see the fall off is not that great. We are just going to move the handles towards each other so that the fall off becomes smaller. Wow, now this looks really great in my opinion. I think the color needs to be changed. Let's make it somewhat reddish or somewhat more pinkish and darker. Good. Now we of course don't want the diffuse texture here, we want emission because we want it to emit light so that even in the background, black color background, we can see the colors, right? Now it will start emitting light. Now what we want to do is we want a Fresnel, a Fresnel around it. Fresnel is basically, I'll show you what Fresnel is. When we do Fresnel, it will just give, you know, the corners will be highlighted even more. So here you can see the corners are being highlighted a lot. So if I just turn off the particle system, then you can see this is without the Fresnel and this is with Fresnel. So Fresnel, the spelling is Fresnel, but it's called Fresnel. Fresnel gives this, the edges are given some reflection. So that is Fresnel. We want to mix it up. with the emission shader. So these are two basic shaders. So mix shader, we are going to use it between them. One goes on the top and one goes on the bottom. And now let's go to the rendered mode, and the background I'm going to make complete black. We want a very black background. We are also going to delete the light. We don't want the light here. So this is how it looks. And we are just going to move with the this handle to give a better look. I think this looks much better. In the modifiers panel itself, let me just move myself aside. In the modifiers panel, we are going to give it one more modifier called subdivision surface, so that it has some, you know, details. So now you can really see the details here, right? You can now see the details. It's very high detailed now. And that's it. We have moved up the subsurface modifier at the top. So in the modifiers panel, we have subdivision surface modifier at the top and displacement modifier below it, and the particle settings are at the last. Particle settings are not basically the modifiers, they are handled from the particle editor nodes, right? And now just make it on. And now let's just select the meta ball from here, the particles, the spikes that we had created, and we want the same material to it also. So we just gave the same material to it. Now I think we can just play with the colors so that this looks really great. I think the Fresnel is too high. We can just decrease the Fresnel, or maybe increase the Fresnel, and just play with the settings right here. Now, also what we want is, we want some sort of, this same needs to be the normal for that also, but we are not going to go for the normals and stuff like that just as of now. This looks great, and I think this is it for this. What just went wrong? Yeah, we are in the rendered mode, so it was giving some hiccups. Cool. Now this looks really, really great. Now let's go to the layout panel and let's see it in the rendered mode. Now this looks great, amazing. Now the last thing that we need to do is, we want to have multiple such coronaviruses at the background. So let's duplicate them, put them here. Let's go to the solid mode so that we can see. Let's just duplicate it, put it here, duplicate it, put it here, duplicate, put it here, duplicate, put it here. Let's go here, just grab them somewhere so that we have some, you know, different things. We don't want this, we'll just grab it right here. Let's go to camera. To go to the camera, we have to just put 0. I think the video is not working quite well. So it's good that I am recording this video so that I will just re-upload the video again. Right. So yeah, this is it. So now let's go to the N panel. Here N panel, and just lock our view. Lock our camera to the view, and now we just want to have all these coronaviruses in focus, right? So here is our camera. I think we can grab it somewhere like this. Just move it in such a way that they are all in the focus area of the camera. So we are just going to move them up and down so that just to create some good visual effects. No such reason of why we are doing this. I think this one can be a bit closer. Let's just grab it right here. I think this is looking really awesome. The last thing that we need to do is to, let's just have some more multiples of this, just to, you know, have some just filling up the screen here. maybe I can duplicate this one to, let's say, here at the corner. We are just duplicating it just to fill up the space. Cool. Now let's see it in the rendered mode. Now this is looking really great. The only thing that is remaining is the camera's focus. So right now we can see the camera is focusing on all of them at once. We don't want that. We want it to focus on just one. I think I can move the this virus even more closer to the camera. Yeah, now this is looking amazing. I just want the camera to focus not on all of them, just to focus on one of them, the front one. So I'm just moving myself away so that you can see what I'm doing. Let's select the camera. If I just click on the edge of the camera, then the camera will be selected, or you can select the camera from here also. Let's go to the camera panel here, right here, and just turn on the depth of field, right? Depth of field. Now depth of field, of course, we can change this focus distance and f-stops and stuff like that by ourselves, but we want the focus on object to this object. So we are just going to pick up this object and object sphere. Now it is this object is in focus, but the f-stop is not correct, so it's not looking great. We're just going to decrease the f-stops so that the background blurs out a little bit, not so much. Now this is looking really, really, really great. I hope you can see what's going on here. I think we can make a few changes to the shader so that it looks even better. We can just decrease the strength a little bit. And now this is looking really great. So now let's just render this out. To render this out, we are just going to go to render and render image. Give it a second. And this is it. This is our awesome, cool looking coronavirus that we have created in Blender in 3D. And that is how you create, you know, 3D animation tutorials and 3D animations for coronavirus or any other viruses or any other microorganisms that you want inside of 3D. Now also what we could have also done is we could have gone for some gases and stuff like that. So if you use Photoshop, then you can just put out some gas like structures here. You know, we can just use some mist or fog to give some interesting look to it. But otherwise this one is also good and it's really looking great. So let's just hop to the comment section. I'll be live for the next few minutes because I don't think it's I'll be live for a few more minutes. I'm just stopping the recording here.